I'm here on the phone with boxing trainer David Ali, who talks to me about Omar Henry's, how about the frustration that he's going through trying to get Omar fights. People sign contracts, say they're going to fight, but don't show up. He's the trainer of Omar Henry, one of the most popular young fighters in the world today, a fighter with over 100,000 followers on Twitter. And for the third time in a row, it seems like Omar's opponents get cold feet right before the fight. Tell me, who's the latest fighter to do this to Omar?
Yeah, Seattle, and Walter Wright. It's actually the fourth opponent. We purposely gave whatever the fight was going to be. We purposely gave the luxury of 60-day notice, which in this sport, as you know, is a luxury. The majority of fighters who get this kind of notice are fighters who are assigned to big promoters, and they get told by that promoter, "You're going to be fighting 2 months from now. Get ready. We don't have an opponent for you, it's a name, but just get ready." We purposely, as part of preparing Omar for the next level, we purposely wanted to have a guy in his camp and his trainer sign on the dotted line 60 days out so that they can prepare for us, so that they can study for 60 days, so that they can do whatever they need to do to try to beat Omar and have that luxury of a 60-day notice by signing a bout agreement.
12-0, 10 knockouts. Well, how do you think Omar Henry would do in the ring with the likes of, like, Pacquiao, Bradley, Devin Alexander, Amir Khan, Paulie Malignaggi?
Well, you mentioned quite a bit of fighters there. Some of those fighters he just flat out knock out. He stopped. But he would do well. He did very well in competing with all of those fighters. I think, personally, that not so much that we need more experience, as far as fighting fighters of that caliber, because we got it. We spent a good 3 months with Floyd. We were in Mexico, tearing through asshole, Margarito. I mean, Omar has that experience fighting those guys.
But let me ask you really quick, Pacquiao Bradley, a quick thought on that.
Sure.
What did you think?
I think it stinks. I think it stinks something horribly, and I don't know what the hell is going on out there with the Nevada Athletic Commission. Everything from missing loaded gloves on a big fight, changing the course of a consummate professional's career, and I'm talking about Miguel Cotto, just changed his whole life by missing that. All the way to funny judges, doing 30 math. I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know what's going on right now with boxing, but it's frustrating. It's frustrating the hell out of me, and I think that people love the sport and fans that follow it. It frustrates them as well. It just doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense for the scorecards. Absolutely no sense at all. It's hard. It's hard, and nobody really wants to shout the conspiracy stuff, because that doesn't really come from a place of intellect or fact. But how could you not? How could you not say that? That those scorecards, that the outcome of that fight, the fight that everybody saw, that there's no funny business going on with that. It's unfortunate for the sport. And at this point, I don't care who the hell Pacquiao fights, I don't care who Bradley fights, I don't care what top rank of Bobby Arms does. I really don't care. It's annoying at this point. It's really annoying. And until the majority of fans start feeling the same way and expressing that, we're not going to see two young lions going in there toe-to-toe, competing. We're going to see a lot of people protecting fighters, ducking. We're going to see a lot of promoters protecting a lot of fighters, and ducking good fights. And that's just everybody loses when it goes down that way.
There you have it. Boxing trainer David Ali frustrated that Omar Henry can't get a quality fight. It's easy for him to take those guys 1-0, 2-0, but he wants quality opponents. Stay tuned for more. EsNews.com. I'm Melissa Pack reporting.